Good morning, and I welcome you all for this 21 days National Refresher Course NRC 2021 on topic Reorienting Extension Education and Advisory Services for Sustainable Development of Farming Community from July 8th to 28th of July 2021, organized by Karnataka Veterinary and Veterinary Animal and Fishery Sciences University, Bidar, and National Agriculture Development Cooperative Limited, NADCL, Baramula. Thank you. Now I handle control over to Dr. Prakash Kumar Rathore. He will handle the proceedings. Please start, sir.
Yeah, good. Thank you, sir. Good morning to all of you. Vaji, sir, am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible as well as you are audible only. Can you turn on your camera? Have you turned off your camera?
Yeah, I can.
Okay, please. Please continue, sir.
So I take this opportunity to welcome our delegates to this 21 days National Refresher Course on Reorienting Extension Education and Advisory Services for Sustainable Development of Farming Community. So we have scheduled this training program from July 8th to 28th of 2021, and in collab, and it is being organized by Karnataka Veterinary Animal and Fishery Sciences University, Bidar, Karnataka, in collaboration with National Agricultural Development Corporation Limited, Baramulla, Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. Firstly, I take this opportunity to thank NADCL for giving us this opportunity to collaborate and organize this training program. And I really appreciate their efforts, because this is, I understand, this is the ninth training program, such a ninth training program they are organizing. And they have already organized previously in collaboration with other partners like ICR, IGFRI, US Raichur, US Dharwad, then West Bengal Veterinary University, then with Raipur Agriculture University, and so on. And it is really a good opportunity for us, so that they have collaborated with us. Firstly, I also take this opportunity to welcome our guests to this inaugural session. Before I introduce our guests and go ahead with the welcome address, I just would like to mention that we have 282 participants who have registered for this particular 21 days training program. And the participants are from agriculture, horticulture, and fisheries background, and even in fact, animal science also. Apart from this, we also have profession wise, we see a good number of participants from KVK personnel, and then university staff, then we have students, and also few of them are the field professionals. So that is really a good number, and I really congratulate all the coordinators as well as all other organizers who have put in their best efforts to bring in good number of participants. Now, firstly, I take this opportunity to welcome all our guests as well as the other delegates to this. Firstly, I take this opportunity to welcome our chief guest, Professor Dr. Onkar Nath Singh, sir, who is the Honorable Vice Chancellor, Birsa Agriculture University, Kanke, Ranchi. So, in fact, he has been very supportive, and actually when the organizers have contacted him, and he was very open enough to agree to, and he has given his consent to for this particular training program. And we thank you very much, sir, for accepting our invitation, and I welcome you to this particular inauguration program. Then I take this opportunity to welcome two of our guests of honor. So one is Professor K.C. Veeranna, who is the registrar of Karnataka Veterinary University. And then we have one more guest of honor, Dr. Hema Tripathi, who is the national coordinator of monitoring and evaluation and environment and social safeguards, and which is actually a part of National Agricultural Higher Education Project of ICR New Delhi. So I thank both of you for accepting our invitation, and I welcome you both for our inauguration program. In fact, both of them are our teachers, and I really welcome both of them for this inaugural. Then next, I take opportunity to thank to welcome our president. In fact, actually, our Vice Chancellor, Dr. H.D. Narayan Swamy, sir, was supposed to join this as a president, but just because of some last moment changes, yesterday he actually had to inform me that actually he had some urgent meeting in the state headquarters, Bangalore. and he is actually having a meeting with principal secretary and few other ministers, and hence actually he could not join. But in his place, actually, we have with us Dr. B.V. Shivaprakash, who is the director of research, and he will be delivering the presidential address, and he will also be conveying the messages of our honorable vice chancellors to all the participants. Then I also take this opportunity to welcome our chairman of organizing committee, Dr. D. Dilip Kumar sir, who is the dean of Veterinary College Bidar, and he has also been very supportive for this particular training program, and I welcome you, sir, for this particular training program. Then we have with us the other important members, like although Dr. Ratna Nishini, she could not join here basically for other some personal problems, but still I really thank her for supporting this event, and actually she has been very supportive for this program. Apart from this, I also welcome another colleague, Dr. Chennap Goda Biradar, who is actually heading the Buffalo Research and Information Center at Dornalli in Karnataka. And at the end, I also would like to welcome our technical team, Majid Ji, and we have Rais Shah sir, as well as his other team members from NADACL, who have been struggling actually from day one in order to get the participants, do all other formalities and keep all these things in a good structured way. At the end, I also would like to thank all the participants for joining this program, and also welcome you all to this particular training program. And all this is a 21 days training program, and would like to just inform you that we will have two sessions daily, one at 11 o'clock and another one at 2:30 in the afternoon. And you have all got you are a part of a WhatsApp group wherein actually we will be sharing your links for the particular lectures, and so that you people can join. And I also would like to just introduce myself, that I am Dr. Prakash Rathod. So associate professor and head, actually I was initially a part of Veterinary College Bidar, but very recently actually I have been again transferred to one of the farm which is around 20 kilometers from this particular college. So with this, I end my formal welcome address for all the participants. And after this, I would like to request our chairman of organizing committee, Dr. D. Dilip Kumar sir, to please give the introductory address to this particular inaugural program.
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Prakash Kumar Rathod. Good morning, everybody. Galaxy of scientists today, they are going to assemble and discuss on the topic sustainable for the development of the farming community, sustainability of agriculture. As we all know, agriculture is a mother of all cultures. So without agriculture, there is nothing. So we can't forget agriculture. We may forget anything else, not the agriculture. Sustainability of the agriculture. When we say sustainability, the agriculture should provide us food and fiber for the present generation without affecting the availability for the future generation. So when we say the food availability, the production is one side, the consumption on the other side. As we are all aware, the population always overpowering the production. So increasing population is a lot of stress on the production. We have the conventional methods of production. So production mainly, as we know, depends upon the soil, the type of the soil we have, and also the nutrients that are available in the soils for the productivity. Prolonged availability, as we are all aware, whenever the crops are grown, there is a depletion of the nutrients from the soil. So replacing of these nutrients is very much essential. So without that, the productivity will not sustain, will not remain. So just not the soil, it is interlinked with so many factors when we say the sustainability. So the land, the water, one of the important components, so without which nothing can happen. Some of the areas are having good water sources, but some of the other areas, if you think, there is a scarcity of water. So recycling of water, we have to think, and judicious conservation and use of the water has to be thought about. So what is another important thing that is important in sustaining the agriculture? So just the conventional methods that were used are not sufficient with the changing scenario, changing time. The technologies have to change. So with the changing technology only we can sustain it, we can forward it to the future generation. So in this context, I thank the organizers. We have very well planned various topic with the scientists who are well versed with those topics, and they will be enlightening for these 21 days from today, 8th onwards to 28th of this month, July. So we have the eminent speakers spread over the different dates in this training. The first one will be by Dr. Rashid Suleiman, Director, CRISP, Banjara Hills, Hyderabad, Telangana. What is new in extension globally? So he will be enlightening us on that topic. Then Dr. Prakash Kumar Rathod, reorienting priorities of extension and advisory services in India during post-COVID-19 pandemic. So as we are all aware, the COVID-19 has paralyzed everything. So everything has come to stand still. But one thing, it has given the new ray of hope. Always in extension, we have one proverb that is reaching the unreached. So earlier, with earlier modalities, reaching the unreached in the interiors due to the road things or communication thing, it was not possible. But now, slowly it is becoming a reality. So just one this example. So we can't imagine all over India getting united and getting communicated in one platform, though physically not nearby, but we are far away, but still are capable of getting. So this is one thing that post-COVID-19 has taught us. And also, Sahaji Sambhaji Pahal, the Assistant Director from Hyderabad, the NH, he'll be speaking on agriculture, extension innovations, and entrepreneurship development for managed initiatives. Our Registrar, Honorable Registrar, Dr. K.C. Veerana, is also an extension person, has worked on a lot of extension projects in our university. Very good experience he's having. He'll be elaborating on reorienting extension education teaching in changing scenario. And also we have Professor P.V.K. Shashidhar, Professor from IGNO, New Delhi. He will be delivering on reorienting extension education teaching in changing scenario. So teaching, really, the virtual teaching has taken place in place of the real teaching, which is definitely good. And also the technology, if it undergoes modification, virtual presence also can be made. So the distance or the geographical barrier, that is the main stumbling block, can be overcome. Then we have Professor P.V.K. Shashidhar from IGNO. So evaluation tools and techniques for the extension research, will be elaborating us on that. Then we have Akila Natarajan, ICR in the Veterinary College, Namakkal from Tamil Nadu. He will be elaborating on successful intervention in climate resilient agriculture, sustainable production. As we are all aware, the climate change is one of the biggest problems. So the rainfall is not very certain. The temperature also increasing year by year. So that is once again stumbling block for the agriculture. With the changing environment, we have to change the techniques of agriculture and also the environmental practices. So also to sustain or to propel forward, this is one of the important requirements to adapt to the changing environment. Then we have Ratna Nashine, Professor and Dean from the Narayanpur, Chhattisgarh. So Madam will be elaborating us on enhancing documentation reporting skills of extension professionals. So this is very important. The documentation part is very, very important. And also the reporting of the skills of the extension persons. So required skills to improve the documentation is essential. Then we have Mahesh Chandra sir, Principal Scientist and Head of the Extension Division, IVRI, Izzatnagar, Bareilly. Do we need exclusive extension policies for India? So definitely very important topic to be once again discussed with regard to the policy matter, because unless the policy is made, it will not become a reality. So this is also a very off topic, I feel. And we have Dr. D. Ami Raju, Principal Scientist, once again from the NARM, Hyderabad, online education system as an innovative extension strategy. Really, this is one of the good techniques. Earlier, we had a lot of problems when we want to bring the farmers in offline mode, transportation and their other commitments in the village, their farming activities were badly affected. Now, with this online mode, with their convenient time, we can reach them, and also the stress of traveling and other work that we are getting hampered can be avoided, and this will be a superior mode of transferring the knowledge in the form of extension. Really, this is the need of the hour, I feel. Then we have also with us Dr. Jiju P. Alex, the Director of Extension from the Kerala Agriculture University, Thrissur, Kerala, Rural Institution for Broadcasting Extension Services, Concepts and Strategies. So, sir will be elaborating on that. We have our own colleague, Dr. Chennappa Gowda Birada, BRIC Yadagiri Livestock Research Station. He will be enlightening us on extension service delivery by multi-stakeholders' experience of livestock tech. Then we have Dr. SVN Rao, Professor Handhead from Puducherry, retired professor, Puducherry Veterinary College. So, Rajiv Gandhi Institute of Veterinary Education and Research from the Puducherry. So, values and competencies for extension professionals. Then we have another eminent speaker with us, a very experienced person, Dr. Sinha Dixit, Principal Scientist and Head ICRISAT, the Patancheru, Telangana. Integrated watershed development through the innovative extension approaches, field experiences. So this is one of the very, very important component. Without water, there is no life. So water conservation, the watershed development programs which are aiming to increase the groundwater level, a lot of projects, a lot of works are going on in that. So there are very good efforts to conserve the water, and their utility in the agriculture is very much important. Then we have Ketu Raman Sivakumar, Principal Scientist from Thiruvananthapuram, once again from Kerala. Scaling up the agriculture innovations, methodological perspectives. Then we have Dr. Vinayak Ramesh Nikam, Scientist of Agriculture Division, NAIP, Pusa, New Delhi. So, formation and functioning of farmer producer organization for inclusive extension and advisory services. Then we have our senior faculty of our university, Dr. K. Satyanarayana, professor and head, who had a lot of experience in Sujala projects, the interstate project. He was the nodal person, and a lot of work beside that he has done in our state. So, and also this village adoption, really very good experience Dr. Narayan sir is having. So, village adoption as extensive extension strategy for sustainable development, field experiences will be enlightened by Dr. Satyanarayan sir. Then we have Dr. Aparna Radhakrishnan, the from once again the Kerala Agricultural University, Kozhikode, Kerala. So, women empowerment and agricultural extension, current status, prospects and challenges. So, they normally say agriculture or the extension in villages to be successful, the woman involvement is very much essential. Without that, the most of the investment activities and all cannot carry forward or cannot sustain. So, that is also one of the important topics that we will be hearing about. Then we have Dr. S.K. Kashyap, Professor and Dean of G.B. Pant College of Agriculture, G.B. Pant University of Agriculture and Technology, the Pant Nagar, Uttarakhand. The sir will be elaborating us on the community radio integrated extension, strategies for grassroots empowerment. Then we have one more faculty from our university, Dr. Jagdishwari, Associate Professor and Head from the Veterinary College, Hassan. So she will be enlightening on development and utilization of mobile application, experience sharing. Then we have Professor S. Ramakumar, Dean, Rajiv Gandhi Institute of Veterinary Education and Research, Krumbapet, Puducherry. For prospective rethinking of behavior among the extension professionals. So this is also a very important topic, because the old habits die hard. They require the newer things to be added. So this is the change of behavior of the extension professional is very, very essential to bring the change in the farming community. Then we have Dr. Sanjeev Maiti, scientist, Division Dairy Extension, ICAR Karnal, Haryana. Climate services, a panacea to impeding climate change on agriculture. The climate is really one of the very, very bothering factor. So that has to be discussed, and we have to face the changes that are occurring in the climate. Then we have Dr. Anantan, principal scientist, ICAR and CP, Mumbai, Maharashtra. Extension for fisheries development, innovation and insights from the field. Then we have one more faculty from our university, Dr. L. Manjunatha, associate professor, Veterinary College, Hebbal, Bengaluru. Coordination of stakeholders in effective promotion of farm technologies, experience of livestock sector. Then we have Dr. Bharat S. Pantaki, principal scientist and head ICAR, the Rajendra Nagar, Telangana, Hyderabad. Participatory technology development in agriculture and allied sector. Then we have Dr. Sudipta Paul, scientist, Division of Extension Education, ICAR, USA, New Delhi. Extension service delivery in Northeastern Hill Region, approaches, challenges, and institutional innovations. We have another eminent scientist, Dr. B.P. Singh, principal scientist, joint director of Extension Division, IVRI Bareilly. Extension strategy for promotion of green fodder production and experience. So green fodder production is one of the important components in the dairy industry. So this is also a very, very important one, topic from the animal husbandry sector point. We have Dr. Mante Sirur, Deputy Director, Agriculture Extension, manage Rajendra Nagar, Hyderabad. So strengthening of agriculture marketing infrastructure to support agriculture in India. Ravanan Raj, Director, the manage Rajendra Nagar, Hyderabad, digital media for agriculture extension. So this is also a very, very important one. The changing scenario, the digital things have become very, very important one. So now if you are not well versed with the digital thing, we are just like uneducated man. The pen and paper era, slowly it is taking back seat. Anything we want to survive, the digitality is very important, that is to be made aware and should be learned. We have from Nagpur, entrepreneurship development in agriculture and allied sector. Then we have Professor N.K. Sudeep Kumar, Director of Extension Education, Tanuas, Madhuram Mill Colony, Chennai. Reorienting extension research linkages, generalist versus specialist. Then one more faculty from our university, Dr. Shivkumar Radar, associate professor, working at Veterinary College, Gadag. So he also has got a vast experience in this Sujala project and other extension activities. So livelihood-led extension approaches for sustainable development. Then we have another eminent speaker, Dr. Nagaratna Biradar, principal scientist, ICAR, Grassland, and Fodder Research Institute, Southern Regional Research Station, Dharwad. Mobilization of youth in agriculture and allied sector field experiences. So this is also very important, because as we are aware, youths are leaving the villages and they are mostly going towards the urban areas. So some of the organizations, they are making an effort to bring back the youth to the villages and to get the revenue, to get the economy in the village level itself, and make their life sustainable in the village atmosphere is one of the good topic and is the need of the hour. Then we have Dr. Farooq Ahmed Agha, the former Associate Director of Information and Publication, Directorate of Extension, Tehri Kashmir University, Agriculture Science and Technology, Kashmir. Application of indigenous technology knowledge, for sustainable agriculture. Dr. Suresh Kumar, Gadwa assistant professor from Gadwasu, Ludhiana, Punjab. He will be speaking on public-private partnership for sustainable development in agriculture and allied sectors. This is also a very important one because the parallel competition of the private, unless it exists, there will not be the outcome, good outcome. So public and private, parallelly, they should have this role play in the sector. So by looking into these all topics, I feel that no stone is left unturned. So almost everything is covered, especially Dr. Rathod taking the full care in designing this particular thing with other eminent scientists, and very good speakers are there. So I wish all the participants to make use of this kind of very valuable training that is going on online, and even in this hard period of COVID-19, it will enlighten us and it will keep us propelling forward. So once again, I thank our university officials who are also given an opportunity and approval for this particular training, and are actually encouraging us for conducting this. And really, once again, all the scientists who are involved here from all our other campuses, and specifically Dr. Prakash Kumar Rathod, who actually has materialized these things. Thank you, one and all. Jai Hind, Jai Karnataka.
Thank you very much, sir, for your introductory remarks. In fact, you have given the complete details of lectures we have in this training program, and you have also been very supportive for us in order to get the things done actually in time. And I really thank you very much for your introductory remarks, and you have tried to focus on the importance of online education, and actually because in the times of pandemic like COVID-19, we all are actually moving towards such a situation of online teaching or online extension. So thank you very much once again, sir. Now I take this opportunity to invite our today's guest of honor, Professor K.C. Veeranna sir, who is a registrar of Karnataka Veterinary University, Bidar, Karnataka. But before I hand it over to him, I just would like to read out his brief profile.
Hello. Yeah, please.
Hello. Hello. Good morning, everybody. Actually, good morning, everybody. Dignitaries in the inaugural sessions and all the respected participants. So actually, I mean, one more important meeting at Secretariat. So in this occasion, I compliment our organizing team for organizing this appropriate training program in the COVID-19 program. Wish you all the best. Thank you.
Prakash?
Hello,
can you hear me? You may have disconnected, just a second. Dr. Prakash?
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yeah, you are audible.
Yes, Prakash, you can hear.
Continue. Yeah, sorry, actually, because I think he was also busy in some meeting. Anyways, I was just reading out his profile. I just would like to complete this so that actually people will be, like, the participants will be knowing him, because he will also come back to us for delivering a lecture.
Can you come closer to the mic, sir? Can you come closer to the mic? Because your audio is dropping.
Yeah, now is it okay?
Yes, my.
So he has actually more than 28 years of experience, and he has actually worked in the capacity of instructor, assistant professor, associate professor, professor, and head. And also he has been the officer on special duty for Veterinary College Gadag and then Veterinary College Shumoga. And he has also been very instrumental in planning, designing, and furnishing different facilities as per VCI and ICI regulations. And he has also worked on different projects. And he has actually been involved in more than 30 training programs and 150 training to the farmers. And he has published more than 70 research papers. And 70 papers he has presented in national, international seminars and conferences. So anyways, actually, since he was busy with another meeting with the principal secretary, in fact, actually, vice chancellor is also there in the same meeting. So we could not get there full time, but I'm sure actually Dr. K.C. Virana sir will be happy to address us in one of his lectures. Now, I move ahead with our one more guest of honor, Dr. Mrs. Hema Tripathi Madam, who is presently the National Coordinator for Monitoring and Evaluation and Environment and Social Safeguard. So this is actually a part of National Agriculture Higher Education Project, ICR New Delhi. In fact, Madam is also a teacher actually when we were a part of ICR, IVRI, when we were undergoing a PhD program. In fact, with one single word, actually, she, Madam, has agreed to be a part of our inaugural program as a chief guest. And we are actually very happy that Madam is here. Before I hand it over to Madam, I would like to just read out our...
Please profile so that our audience can see the
Akash, your voice is dropping. You come to closer to the mic. Prakash, you are not audible.
Now, okay.
You continue.
So she did her graduation from G.B. Pant University, Pantnagar in 1983.
I have some echo, actually, that's a problem.
You have logged in with two accounts. You have logged in with two accounts. You check it out.
Disconnect one.
Now?
Yeah, much better.
I think, is it okay?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, continue.
Can you hear me?
Yes, please go.
No, but can you hear me now?
Yes,
you go ahead.
Yes, Dr. Prakash, you can go ahead now.
Yeah, and Madam did her MS, MSc and PhD in Extension Education from IVRI Izzatnagar, Uttar Pradesh in 1987 and 1991 respectively. And she joined ARS services in August 1991 and worked in IVRI Izzatnagar for 25 years in different capacities, including as a program coordinator of KVK for 13 years. After that, she worked as principal scientist at CIRB, that is Central Institute for Central Institute of Research on Buffaloes, HISAR. And currently she is working as national coordinator, as I already mentioned, under NAHEP project, of which is a World Bank project under Agriculture Education Division in ICR. Dr. Tripathi Madam made excellent contribution in the area of animal science extension. So her major focus of research has been demand-driven research, quantifying the roles of rural women, occupational health hazards, drudgery reduction, and entrepreneurship development in dairying, developing various methodologies, attitude scales, and she has completed more than 11 institute projects and 4 externally funded projects. During her 13 years tenure as program coordinator of KVK IVRI, Madam has made outstanding contribution by establishing animal-based demonstration units under integrated farming system and led the farmers to adopt this system for augmentation of their income. During her period, actually, even IVRI KVK bagged the best KVK award in Zone 4 by ICR in 2011. Madam's research, innovation, models and methodologies and interventional strategies have been duly reflected in more than 300 research papers, books, abstracts, bulletins, popular articles, etc. She has written 4 teaching and training manuals, 2 books, technical bulletins, reports, and majority of and 4 educational mobile apps which are available on Google Play Store. Madam has been the faculty of extension education at IVRI since 1994 and had more than 24 and PhD students and 32 students as member of advisory committee. One of our PhD students has received a coveted Jawaharlal Nehru Award for best PhD thesis of ICR in 2012. Madam has several awards, honors and recognition to her credit based on scientific and academic work. Peer reviewed recognitions such as notable amongst them are the Best Teacher Award of IVRI, Bharat Ratna C. Subramanian Award for Outstanding Teachers in Teacher of ICR in 2016, Best Zonal KVK Award in 2011, Professor Y.P. Singh Memorial Award from Indian Society of Extension Education 2019, besides the awards for several best research papers by Indian Dairy Association, best poster, popular articles. In fact, these are all the testimony of being an outstanding researcher, extension worker, and a teacher from the madam's side. This is that you have been you have agreed to be a part of our inaugural program as a guest of honor, madam. I now hand it over to you to please deliver the address to our participants.
Thank you, Dr. Prakash. Sabiko, mera namaskar. Chief guest of today's inaugural session, Professor O.N. Singh, Honorable Vice Chancellor, Birsa Agriculture University, Ranchi. We have with us the Director of Research, Karnataka Veterinary Animal and Fishery Science University, Bidar, Dr. Veerana, one of my colleagues at IVRI, presently is the Registrar at Bidar, Dr. Dilip Singh, who is the Dean Veterinary College, Prakash Rathod, and Dr. Biradar, and all my dear participants. Really, it is an honor for me to be here today to participate in the inaugural function of the 21 days training program on the reorienting extension education and the advisory services for sustainable development of the farming community that is being arranged by the Karnataka Veterinary Animal and Fisheries Science University Bidar and NADCL Baramulla. It gives me a great pleasure to be here amongst all the extension fraternity. I can just feel the energy here, while the subject of the training program is really, really very important in today's context. When we talk about the extension and the advisory services, it is across the world helping in addressing the farmers' needs over the years. It is not a new concept. Such services are multidisciplinary in nature and can grow much more sturdier if they are continued with that supply of the timely research outputs. But we are very less disseminate our research, whatever we develop in the form of the models, in the form of the scales, approaches and all that. And so if we timely disseminate this information, whatever we produce in the form of the research, as well as the information which we generate as an output of the research, that may be in the form of the publication, maybe advisory services, so that helps in the planning, or that can be an input for planning the implementation of the extension interventions and framing our policies in addition to the contribution to the discipline of the science. So we can say that India is in the process of the transforming agriculture extension and technology transfer system. And now the system has become more demand driven. It is becoming more responsive to the farmers' need. We can say now the present extension system is at the crossroads and in the process of the paradigm shift in its approaches. There is growing concern about the focus of the extension and the extended role of extension as extension of the extension, wherein we have now including the market-aware extension and market-oriented extension and farmer-to-farmer extension, participatory extension, in our approaches. So when we talk about the extension, we have to see the right information at the right time and by using the appropriate channels is very, very crucial for the farmers to take the decision at the appropriate time. For example, in agriculture, if we provide the information at the right time, what quantity of the fertilizers to be used, what pesticides to be used, at what time, where to sell the produce, at what cost, what are the channels available. So these are the things that all needs extension system to be more decentralized, participated in the demand-driven approaches. So it can be said that the extension advisory services play a major role in strengthening our farmers in terms of the technical, in terms of the managerial, in terms of the organizational capacities. But they need the frequent renewal of these capacities to deal effectively with the evolving challenges of this farming community. If we see the history of the extension, it is the responsibility of the public extension system to provide all information to the farmers. We all know the state agencies and the public extension system, universities, all public extension system that has been overburdened in these days. Now you know that they are performing more non-extension works like distribution of subsidies, inputs, and completing the targets given under the various programs. And then left very, very little space to attend the core extension advisory services on the new practices and the technologies. Another major concern in the extension is that most of the agriculture extension officers' posts are vacant in many states. The ratio of, if we see the ratio of the extension workers to the farmers, it is as low as, presently it is 1:1162 at national level. Whereas that means one agriculture officer is farming to the 1,162 farmers against the recommended ratio of the 1,750. So we can see these are the various challenges, not only this, but the lack of trained field staff. Our staff is also not well trained, as well as the resources which are required to provide the advisories to the farmers, to our farmers are also not, they are not well equipped, or we can say they are lacking. Nowadays, the information needs of the farmers are increasing, we know. They are shifting from the subsistence to market-oriented farming. And this leads to that the demand or the information needs are also increasing. They do not require only the production practices. They require the variety of the information on the modern and scientific approaches to reach the large number of farmers. So we have to see this thing. Again, we can see the diversity, the agroecological situations, socio-ecological conditions, cultural conditions of our farmers that also call for the different or the alternative sources of the information dissemination. So these are some of the challenges before us. And so this shows that if such problems are existing in our system, then the objective of doubling the farmer's income by 2022 cannot be achieved without the successful delivery of the agriculture extension delivery system and the services in India. So there is an urgent need to reprioritize the existing extension system, that is from the traditional food security perspective, to be the more market-led extension and to be more diversified and focusing on the high-value agriculture. So these are very, very important. Now we have the several channels with us doing the extension work. Number of the input dealers are doing, private companies are doing, farmers producer organizations, cooperative services, NGOs. Now even the post offices, they are now active in providing the right information to the farmers, providing the forward and the backward linkages also. But we see that all these agencies are working in the isolation. There is no convergence and no coordination amongst these. So the prime step in reprioritizing the extension system is the strengthening the link between the research extension, whether it is the between the public, private, and the third sector. So linkage is very important, the coordination and the convergence is very important. Another important is the communication. Communication of the quality research findings is essential to identify the, so that we can identify the problems and we can give the solution. If we see the roles of the extension advisory providers, that was tremendous during the lockdown in safeguarding the farmers from the agrarian distress. Farmers were in distress. Even today, during the pandemic, extension services and the extension support or the marketing support, that is being provided by the public sector, private sector that have significantly contributed in the sustainable agriculture. So we can say to the and now the we have seen that the quantum of the production, the agriculture produce was the highest during this event in spite of the lockdown. So the farmers, because the farmers were linked to the market, input agencies, and which were never realized before. Under the lockdown situation, that could minimize the input of the supply. There was no problem of the input supply chain disruptions. So similarly, the promotion during this time, the farmers producers organizations were promoted. And by seeing the potential of the farmers producers organization, Government of India has launched a new central sector scheme, that is the formation and promotion of the 10,000 farmers producer organizations in India. Here the our KVKs, one of the extension advisory service providers, have been entrusted to this particular responsibility to form their potential. So during the last decades, number of the different models and the approaches were promoted by the different organizations with different levels of the results and the impacts. Since concept of extension is dynamic in nature, so reorientation of the priorities is also very important with the vast network of the where the number of the stakeholders are available and with the effective approaches. Maybe the utilization of the social media, human resource development, public-private partnership, farmers group. So, but all empirical efforts are needed to develop the reliable, location-specific, gender-sensitive. Very important, the gender-sensitive. Dr. Sabha has already told in the beginning when he was reading the contents. At that time also, number of the topics have been covered under this. The content which is made by the organizers, that is really very, very nice, and everything has been involved in this particular course. So that is, if we see the extension as a term that is open to a variety of interpretations. Each extension agent probably have a different interpretation, own understanding what is extension based on the past experiences. So wherever he is working. In other words, we can say there is no single definition of extension which is universally accepted, which is applicable in all situations, because it is not a one discipline. It is not stand alone discipline, and it requires that subject matter which needs to be communicated with the specific group of the target group. Farmers, maybe the farmer, maybe the women, maybe the youth, maybe the different contents in different streams. So that is, and for being the extension personnel, there are two important skills that need to be developed by them. I think that must be in the content, that one should be the basic technical subject matter skills or the competences are very important. That is the process skill. Or we can say the functional skill or soft skills. Or another is the application of the technical subject matter competences of the core or the core skills. That means how to organize the programs, how to organize the group discussions, how to organize the method demonstrations and all that. And how to organize the refresher trainings. So faculty responsible for teaching any extension, whether it is the veterinary extension, dairy extension, agriculture extension, fisheries, home science, all must have these two type of the competencies. One is the subject matter, other is the extension. So when we talk about the extension advisory services, the timely information I told you here, the community radio can play a very important role and the potential role to connect with the local people because of their dialects and with their participation. As this is also community radio, the Pannagar from Pannagar, one of the lectures is there. So that is very important, and people will learn that how to use the community radio for dissemination of the information and the advisory services. Another I told you, the use of the social media. That is very, very important tool these days to reach a large number of the people in the interactive mode. Maybe the Facebook, maybe WhatsApp group, maybe Twitter, YouTube, and so many digital media tools. ICT initiatives are very important, and these digital initiatives now playing a very, very important role. And digital interventions with voice messages, text messages, emails, that can tackle the unforeseen situations and the emergent problems to the with our clientele in the futuristic extension delivery systems also. when we say the ICT tools, our extension agents should be very, very trained, and they must be skilled before saying that, before providing any tool. Like if we are providing the tab and they are not skilled to use these tabs. So the providing the skills or training is very important before using the ICT tools to the extension workers. Our extension needs, as I told you, the information needs of the women farmers, that is our extension needs, where the 70, more than 70% of the tasks are shouldered and the responsibility of the women as a whole. So their contribution varies within the enterprise, cost, location, region. So we have to make our plans with the how to deal with the women farmers according to their convenience at the short duration with subject of current importance, practical orientation, and they can be reached with the mobile telephony also by the regular and timely sending the advisories also with the reminders also that can be done. So we have to, we need a specific methodologies to deal with the gender sensitive, that is gender sensitive approaches are required. And there is a farmer to a farmer extension may be promoted with very care by trickling down the information vertically as well as horizontally. And they can also use as a guidepost for the future extension. Because and here, when we say the future farmer to farmer extension, that means this is farmers rely on the advisories given by them. So we can recruit some of the progressive farmers as a farmer's friend. We can give some monthly honorarium that is also to the progressive farmers, and they can go to the village for this extension work. And similarly, but last but not the least, that there is a need of holistic approach, I can say, wherein the public extension system, the private extension system, ICT mode of extension system, PPP mode of extension, that should be in the integrated manner for the farmers for sustainable agriculture, so that the agriculture productivity can be enhanced with minimum risk and without much disturbing the natural resources to meet the targets of the doubling the farmers. So in this context, the aim of this course is very, very relevant, wherein you are going to sensitize your faculty, scientists, field professionals, students, KVK persons, whosoever is involved in the extension and the advisory services to revisit the strategies and the concept so that can bring the paradigm shift in the extension delivery system. So I hope and understand this 21 days training program will definitely contribute to the participants in understanding and updating their knowledge with respect to the different roles and the approaches of the various actors, and that can play a providing a different agriculture extension advisory services to attain the National Agriculture Development Goal, and with improving in the livelihood of rural livelihood and by maintaining the sustainability of the natural resources within the country. With this view, what I feel that I should communicate, so these are the some of the areas I thought that I must interact and I must give you the thought on these aspects. So with these few words, I am thankful to the organizers for inviting me as a guest of honor in this particular function, in the inaugural function. The participants are huge in nature, so I think this will benefit to not only to them personally but to the state, to the country also. So thank you very much.
Thank you very much, madam, for your address to all our participants. In fact, this you have tried to actually highlight on the importance of technology as well as actually the role of extension in improving the livelihood of the farmers as well as in improving the sustainability. Ultimately, actually, it is also very clear that actually we need to improve or update the skills and competencies of our extension professionals so that we all together can contribute in improving the sustainability or as well as the livelihood of our farming community. Thank you very much, madam, for your address. Next, it is the turn of our today's chief guest address. We all know that actually we have Dr. Omkar Nath Singh sir, who is the Vice Chancellor of Birsa Agriculture University, Ranchi, Jharkhand. So before I hand it over to him, I would like to give a brief profile of our chief guest today. So he is originally a principal scientist of NICER, and he has worked at, he is presently also working as a technical member for Plant Variety Protection Appellate Tribunal of Intellectual Property Appellate Board under Ministry of Commerce and Industry, Government of India. He also has worked as director as well as head of Division of Crop Improvement at ICR National Rice Research Institute, Cuttack. And he was also a senior scientist at ICR at Umora, Uttarakhand. Then he was also assistant and associate professor at Narendra Dev University of Agriculture and Technology, Faizabad. Then he was also assistant professor at Dr. Rajendra Prasad, Central University, Bihar. So, and he's basically an expert in agriculture genetics and plant breeding. And he has been involved in developing more than 30 rice varieties with special reference to aerobic rice in areas where there is acute shortage of water. So he has led several projects which are funded by funded nationally, internationally, and guided several postgraduate students. Just to say a few of his awards, I just would like to say that he's bestowed with several awards like Distinguished Scientist Award, BioVet Fellowship Award, Best Principal Scientist Award, and he is also the Fellow of Indian Society of Genetics and Plant Breeding. And he has got more than 120.
Dr. Prakash, can you come closer to the mic?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that's much better.
Yeah. So he has got actually more than 120 research papers in national and international reputed journals, and he has contributed to.
Your voice is breaking, Dr. Prakash. Can you come closer to the mic?
Yeah, I'm actually close to the mic.
So can you be a bit louder then?
Yeah, and ultimately we are very happy and proud that he has agreed to be a chief guest for our inaugural program today. And I just would like to request again our Vice Chancellor of Agriculture University, Ranchi, Professor Dr. Omkar Nath Singh, sir, to please address the participants of the inaugural program. VC sir, please.
Dr. Prakash.
Sir, is he here?
Hello?
Hello, can you hear?
Yeah, I can hear you.
No, but I have requested sir to address the participants.
Basically, your voice has dropped considerably. Maybe he might not have heard you. Can you repeat?
Yeah, I request Dr. Omkar Nath Singh, sir, the Honorable Vice Chancellor of Bissa Agriculture University, Kanker Ranchi, to please address the participants of the inaugural program. Is it okay?
Yeah, I don't know if he's here.
He's here. He's very much present, but the voice has not come.
Yeah.
He's here. His PA, with his PA account, he has entered.
Yeah.
Can you call him up and say that?
But his voice has not come.
No, once somebody speaks, they get to the main part, because he's not speaking, that's why voice is not coming. Dr. Omkar Nath Singh, hello?
Prakash, phone number is there, phone at
there. Sir, your voice is not coming. Sir is here.
Sir,
आवाज नहीं आ रही आपकी.
सर, अनम्यूट प्लीज.
हेलो. There's some issue with the device sir is using. Sir is already on mute, but we are not able to hear him. Can anyone help there?
Prakash, talk to him over phone.
Not audible, sir. You might have to change input mic on your computer.
He's not picking the call actually.
He's already on mute, but I don't think his mic is working. Maybe the mic on the laptop or the headphone is not working. We need to change the audio source for the recording. Now it is muted. Can you unmute? Now it's muted.
Hello, sir.
Can you unmute now? Because it's on mute.
थोड़ा अनम्यूट एक बार अनम्यूट करके ट्राई कर सकते हैं सर.
The mute is the microphone. It shouldn't be red. If it is red, that means you are on mute. At the bottom of the screen, where you see all the participants and all the meeting info, there is a camera icon and there is a microphone icon. If it is microphone icon is red, you have to click on it and change it to white so that you are audible. Right now it must be red, which means you are on mute.
No, sir, it is unmuted, but still we are not.
Now it is muted. I see the mute icon on you.
It is muted.
It's muted right now. Right now it's muted. It was unmuted before. Even then we did not have any audio. Now it is muted, so we can't have any audio. Can you unmute?
I think they are not able to listen also. I don't know. इनपुट सोर्स में प्रॉब्लम लग रही है मुझे लगता है.
यस यस आई थिंक देयर इज एन इनपुट सोर्स.
या
मे बी स्टीरियो मिक्स इज सिलेक्टेड और डिफॉल्ट ऑडियो डिवाइस इज नॉट सिलेक्टेड. दैट इज द इशू दे आर फेसिंग आई गेस.
यस यस
हेलो
या यू ऑडिबल सर.
हां कैन यू हियर मी.
यस यस
ओके. एस्टीम्ड डॉक्टर हेमा त्रिपाठी नेशनल कोऑर्डिनेटर नाहप ICR, respected deans and directors of the university hosting this program, participants from different part of the country. Indeed, it's I am very much thankful to organizing committee for inviting me in inaugural session of the 21 days training program entitled Reorienting Extension Education and Advisory Services for the Sustainable Development of Farming Communities through online mode. I am highly appreciate you to team members for conducting these type of the program under COVID pandemic situations. The topic chosen is very important for the faculty, scientists, field professional and students involved in the extension education and advisory services to revisit the strategic and concepts so as to bring about a paradigm shift in the extension delivery mechanisms for the farming community. Extension and advisory services are very, very important for growth of the farming communities by disseminating current research and important technologies. Advisory services is multidisciplinary in nature and can grow is multidisciplinary in nature and can grow stronger through a sustained supply of the vital elements like changing concept, approaches, tools and techniques. Further, the information generated through extension research can be an important input for planning, implementing, extension, inventions, all those things. There is a widespread concern that extension and advisory services should be applied in nature, and hence all theories and models should prove to be applicable with the implications on the sectors for which it is developed. Further communication of the research findings through quality publications, extension and advisory services is very essential to ensure identification of relevant problems that match with the context and contributes to uptake of the information generated and ultimately benefiting the farming communities. In this context, this course will be helpful to sensitize and update the faculties, field professionals, scientists, extension specialists, students and entrepreneurs about recent advances in extension education and advisory services for effective dissemination of the information and technology, to identify and share the best practices in extension education and advisory services, to focus on identification of the constraints and challenges in extension education and advisory services, and find suitable solutions and strategies for sustainable development of the farming communities. And also to create a quality discussion forum of the professionals through interactions and dialogue between experts and participants based on the diverse research and extension service activities. Friends, as you all know, extension is basically vehicle for fulfilling the dream of the government for doubling the farming income of the farming communities. So you people are very important as far as doubling the farming income is concerned. And our government is very much serious about this one to fulfill the need. I mean, the doubling the farming income of the farmers. I hope that my friends will certainly come after 21 days. I mean, be the full deliberations that what will be, I mean, a very good recommendations which can go a long way for fulfilling the dream of our government. Friends, I will not take much time. I think you all know Dr. Gopalji Trivedi, a very old, means 92 years old, extension scientist who has been vice chancellor in late 80s. He is visiting our university. So I was also, because I just joined when he was vice chancellor. So I was little bit with him. So hope you will excuse me for those things, friends. But my specific message is that you people are the area, are the vehicle of disseminating the technologies for doubling the farming income. With these words, I thank the whole organizing committee and Dr. Prakash Kumar, along with Director of Research and Deans of the universities. And I hope that the message given by Dr. Hema Tripathi will be very much useful for the participants. Thank you so much, friends.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much.
Majid sir, can you hear?
Yes, I'm hearing.
Yes, we can hear. Yes,
sir, thank you very much for your address to all our participants. It is really a pleasure for us having you here as the chief guest. And in fact, we will come out with, because I think you might have already gone through our lectures, and we have tried to bring in all types of contents so that our participants will be actually living this training program with good competencies and improvement in their skills. Thank you very much once again, sir, for sparing your valuable time for this inaugural program.
Thank you so much.
Next, it is our turn of the presidential address. In fact, as I already mentioned, our vice chancellor, sir, was supposed to join this, but due to some urgent meeting, he could not join us. But we have our director of research from our university, Dr. V.V. Shivaprakash, sir. So we will be giving the messages from our vice chancellor, as well as we'll be delivering the presidential address. Over to Dr. V.V. Shivaprakash, sir, please.
Thank you, Dr. Prakash Kumar. Good morning, Professor Karnath Singh Ji, Honorable Vice Chancellor, Vissa Agriculture University, Ranchi, who is a guiding force and who has given a lot of encouraging words to us, Srimati Dr. Hema ji, National Coordinator, ICR, New Delhi, Registrar of our University, Professor K.C. Veeranna, Chairman of the Organizing Committee, Dr. Dilip Kumar, Dean, Veterinary College, Bidar, Course Director, Dr. Prakash Kumar Rathod, Course Co-Directors, Dr. Chanapogoda Biradar, and all other dignitaries. In fact, I feel privileged to be part of this inaugural session of National Refresher Course on Reorienting Extension Education and Advisory Services for Sustainable Development of Farming Community. I'm very much impressed because of many reasons. First of all, the subject itself, the extension, valuable tool. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
I'm very much impressed because of many reasons. First of all, the subject itself, the extension, which is a very important tool to disseminate the technologies to the end users, the farming community, and all the stakeholders. And then the various topics selected for this 21 days program, and the large number of experienced experts involved in this training course. The Madam Srimati Hema Tripathi ji already narrated that why there is a need to reorient the extension education. She mentioned that the extension is on the crossroads today. This is because of many reasons. To say a few more, because of land holding. Earlier, farmer had lot of large land holdings. Now land fragmentation is there, his land holdings is small. So our extension strategies need to be changed. The climate change, the pollution, the change in crop policies, the change of farmer's attitude in selecting the crops, whether food crops or economic crops, the change in animal rearing system. Earlier, bullocks dependent agriculture was there. Nowadays, it's more of mechanized agriculture. The change in buffaloes. So there is a change in fishery sector also, both in freshwater and coastal. And these are all again related with the environmental pollution. Hence, there is a need to reorient the extension education. Earlier, the extension, when we were students, we were taught that the extension has to be given through lectures, demonstrations, exhibitions, preparing the posters, charts, and overhead projectors, so on. But now, due to advancement in technology, the digital, online, mobile app development, the computer modes, and the live demonstrations, the establishment of role models, standard models of a farm, all these have come up. Hence, there is a need to reorient the extension education. In this regard, a national refresher course has been organized by Karnataka Veterinary Animal and Fisheries Sciences University in association with the National Agriculture Development Cooperative Limited, Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. I am very much thankful on behalf of university to NADCL for being part with us, and all the dignitaries, experts, for their active participation in this national refresher course. I hope all the participants will take a good benefit of these deliberations. See, now earlier the refresher training courses used to be in the classrooms or in a seminar halls. But since now it is online mode, it has got several advantages too. We can participate with our leisure time also, and we can carry out other works without moving to another place. This saves not only time, but also the labor, the travel, the expenses, and it ensures our safety also. And not only the participants, even the faculty, the veterinarians, the agriculture officers, the fishery people are also participating. And the courses have been designed in a broader way, which is suited to the agriculture, fishery, and animal husbandry sectors. I hope all the participants, students, will take benefit of this. I am very much impressed that large number of the students and the officers have enrolled over 282. It's very good. I hope this is the beginning. And very good topics like the whether extension policies are required for our country or not. Like that newer topics are there. What is new in extension? What are the values and competencies for the extension? Do we need I hope that they will be discussed. Thank you. Thank you one and all. Jai Hind.
Thank you, sir, for your presidential address. Thank you. Can you hear me?
Yes, yes, you are audible.
So now it is the turn of actually Dr. Chennapgowda Biradar, sir, who is actually the head of our Buffalo Research Institute at Dornally. But before I give it to him for a formal vote of thanks, I would like to thank once again our Director of Research, Dr. B.V. Shuprakash, sir, for delivering the presidential address. And he has also conveyed the messages of our Vice Chancellor. So thank you, sir. Thank you once again. At the end, I would like to hand it over to Dr. Chennapgowda Biradar, who is actually taking who will deliver the formal vote of thanks for this inaugural program.
Dr. Prakash, when people in 2020 March, when people earmarked that world after COVID will be different, now with this training, I feel it is 100% true. After COVID-19, there will be a lot of changes. Reaching the unreached has become very much easy compared to the earlier days. Now we need to reorient extension education and advisory services, not just because of globalization, liberalization, not just because of Millennium Development Goals for Sustainable Development. It is also just because of COVID also. So in this background, we are Karnataka Veterinary Animal and Fishery Sciences University. Bidar is organizing a 21 days national refresher course on reorienting the extension education and advisory services for sustainable development of farming community. For this program, we had a chief guest, Professor Omkar Nath Singh, who in his chief guest address, who encouraged the organizers for organizing such programs. And also he has thrown a light on importance of the topic and the present context. And we are very much thankful on behalf of Veterinary University Bidar and also on behalf of NADACL, I extend my sincere gratitude and thanks to Professor Omkar Nath Singh, Honorable Vice Chancellor, Birsa Agriculture University, Ranchi. We are also thankful to our beloved teacher and Dr. Hema Tripathi Madam, who is a National Coordinator, National Agriculture Higher Education Project, who called upon all the participants to disseminate more, and whatever the things have been done, it needs to be disseminated. And at the same time, she stood with us by telling that extension is overloaded and overburdened. It's not just information needs are increasing, but also the demand for information is instant one. Time in now 24/7 nature of service needs to be done even in the extension also. So for encouraging words, and madam, we in the Karnataka extension, we are still carrying a legacy of IVRI extension, starting from Dr. K.C. Virena to Dr. Prakash Rathod and myself. We are all well versed with IVRI extension. Thank you, madam, for being a part of our training, and we would look forward to you in many of our programs in the days ahead. Thank you, ma'am. I'm also thankful to Professor K.C. Virena, who is a registrar of Veterinary University and who also happens to be an extension stalwart of South Karnataka, who is a man behind implementing several extension livelihood projects across Karnataka, and who was nowadays several state governments are giving bucks, rams, sheep and goat. These were the programs conceived by Dr. K.C. Virena exactly a decade back, and now the governments are replicating it. And though he has left the meeting, we are very much thankful to him for his guidance, for his encouragement, and as well as for guiding entire extension faculty. And we are also thankful to Dr. D. Dilip Kumar sir, who is a dean and teacher of many of organizers, who elaborated a schedule in detail and who is a strengthening force in organizing such type of courses at Veterinary College Bidar. And we are very much thankful to you, sir. And though Professor H.D. Narayan Swamy sir is not there in the meeting because of pre-occupied schedule, I am also thankful on behalf of organizers to our Vice Chancellor, Dr. H.D. Narayan Swamy sir, who always encourages such type of programs. And in his absence today, our Director of Research has presided over the program, Dr. B.V. Shivaprakash sir, who is a stalwart surgeon, large animal surgeon known across the India, and who is again from IVRI, and he is heading our directorate. And sir, thank you for being a part of this program and for giving presidential remarks. And again, I should be thankful to two persons, Dr. Prakash Kumar Rathod and Dr. Majid, who has made this thing possible. Because when he started and when he asked me, Prakash, already 6-7 trainings are over, so whether participants will come or not, I was doubting. Then no doctor, let us try. He in turn told me, encouraged me also, and we could able to turn over around 200 participants, which is probably because of our nationwide contact from IVRI to Karnataka has also helped us to reach the people across. So I am thankful and I congratulate Dr. Prakash Rathod and Dr. Majid for organizing such a training program, and all the coordinator, of course, Dr. Shivakumar Reddy, Dr. Satyanarayan sir, Dr. Manjunath L, Dr. Jagadishwari madam, who all encouraged us, and Dr. Gopal GT, Dr. Harish, Dr. Anant Rao Desai, who were all behind this program, and I extend my thanks to them. And last but not the least, many of our faculty, Veterinary University faculty, are also part of it. I extend thanks to them, and all the participants, I request them to stay with us for 21 days and to participate, to discuss, to elaborate, and definitely we will be able to, if not like a offline training program, we may not give tedious program, but definitely we will be able to sensitize on various areas, starting from extension policy to the public-private partnership, starting from a livestock service delivery to the ICT, IT, every area we will be able to elaborate. And thank you for joining us. And I once again thank all the dignitaries. And with this, I would like to conclude my vote of thanks. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Chennapoda sir, for your formal vote of thanks. I would like to, just before I hand it over back to Majid ji, I just would like to say that we have actually the next session at 2:00. And for all our sessions, we will be sharing the links just around 10 or 15 minutes in advance in the WhatsApp group, so that you people can join accordingly. And that is all I would like to say in the inauguration session. I thank you all once again for being a part of this. Thank you, sir, as well as thank you, madam, for being a part of this. I request Majid ji to please take over.
Thank you, Prakash ji. Also, I would want to add this, that we have already gotten a list from the organizing committee of the participants, and we'll be sharing the links prior to the event on their emails. What is the difference between the link on the WhatsApp and what is the difference between the link on the email? For the email link, they don't need to be accepted in the group. They can automatically join in. I prefer participants clicking on the email link. That way they can join directly. And I would want to thank everyone involved and all the participants for showing such discipline during the presentation. Again, I request whenever you join the meeting, only join. No need to present. That disturbs the presentation session. Also, I would want to say, if you're not in an office environment, please turn off your cameras, because this session is being recorded and going to be uploaded on YouTube. And also mute yourself whenever you join. Thank you everyone for being such lovely participation. It was so nice of you to join us. We'll be joining again in a separate session, which will be 2:30. Link will be shared a few minutes prior to that session on their email or participants email as well as on the WhatsApp group. So please join us at 2:30 for the first session that is going to be starting at 2:30. Thank you, everyone. Thanks a lot. Let's consider the session to be concluded. Thank you, everyone, for joining in. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.